Yes, sir. Sir, please start.
आउने के प्रेजेंटिंग कर छी देखो जी
सर मु प्रेजेंटिंग कोच सर अमित त्रिपाठी कोच सर
पीपीटी मु करबि त
सर मु पीपीटी टा प्रेजेंट कर छी आपन कहि देबे प्रेजेंटेशन दे देबे
ठीक अछि ठीक अछि आपन ए पीपीटी देखाउ छ त
यस सर मते आपन खाली नेक्स्ट स्लाइड हां यस सर मते स्लाइड खाली कहि देबे नेक्स्ट स्लाइड को जानतु कि मु नेक्स्ट स्लाइड को पळैबे सर
Good morning to the learners. We will be starting discussion on partnership DIA. DIA 4 block 1. The subject is financial accounting and the topic is related to partnership. We'll go to the next slide. First, we'll go with the introduction. We know that there was the single form of business organization was known as sole trader. Due to various limitations of sole proprietorship or sole trader, a single business, the partnership came into account. What are the limitations of partnership, sole trader? Sole trader does not have any act, nor does not have any rules and regulation. Anybody having any business can change his business. You might have seen the seasonal business, person doing Rakhi business, person doing kite business, person doing holi business, person doing the cracker business. So they do not have any fixed form of rules and regulation. So in order to have some fixed form of rules and regulation, the concept of partnership came into account. Another limitation was the only one person is responsible for the business. He is himself the owner, he is himself a manager, himself a knocker. Everything he does, he himself purchases, himself sells, himself maintain accounts. So it's become very difficult on the part of the sole trader to maintain specialization of account. That's why the concept of partnership account and the risk is bear by solely by one person. That's why the concept of partnership came into account. These are two very, very important reasons. So what is a partnership? Partnership has an act, Partnership Act 1932. This is a very important thing which sole trader doesn't have till now. See, the act is from 1932. Till now, it has not been changed. And the function and aspect of partnership is under this act. And partners mean, always you know, meaning of partner means two person, minimum two person or two or more than two. In case of sole trader, there is only one person. So when another person is added, so you are sharing the expertise, you are sharing the knowledge, so risk is shared, so you get specialization of division of work. And suppose he's a guy from accounts or commerce, he's another guy is from arts, so the accounts guy, the commerce guy can maintain accounts. There is a specialization, some type of specialization is there. You know, partnership is a business where agreement takes place. And the agreement we know is known as partnership deed. In partnership, it is a special term known as partnership deed, where it is takes place between two or more person and agreed to be co-owner. Why it is known as co-owner? Because both are owner. More than one owner is known as co-owner. And they distribute the responsibility because among the organization and share the income and losses. They share the profit, they share the loss on the basis of the profit sharing ratio, on the basis of the capital contribution. We'll be covering this on the later part of the slide. The specific law explains the partnership is the association between two or more individuals. You know, I've already have told, or parties who are asked to share profit from the business and the supervision of manner on behalf of other members. Either one partner act on behalf of the another partner, or the both partner have mutual faith or implied authority on each other. Next slide. What is a business partnership? It is a legal relationship. We know we are telling this agreement. So it is only a deed. It is a written agreement. Always we prefer written agreement. And because one of the partner invest money in the business and another partner get benefit, so there may be quarrels, confusions, and there may be legal cases in future. There may be some problem. So that it is treated as a written agree. attached with the business, must register with all state variables. Wherever which state you want to do the business, you have to register it. So where you have to register? You have to register in register of partner firm, ROF, register of firm. You have to go to the office and put the name to the partnership business. You have to give details of the partners. You have to give details of the accounts. We will maintain the accounts. You have to details of the name and address of the partner, the guarantor who is standing for the partner, whether the partner he is active partner, sleeping partner. Active partner means a partner who gives actively or manages actively the business, or give time to the business. Sleeping partner who does not give time to the business, only is a partner simply by name. Every state we know has a different kinds of partnership, and we have to know how to register. Next slide. Features of partnership, very, very important things. See, agreement. Already I have told, when 2 person come to decide something, there should be a written agreement. Oral agreement is not accepted. So 2 person coming together, they should agree on certain things. There should be mutual consent of both the parties regarding the capital contribution or regarding the profit sharing ratio. You know, partnership means 2 or more person. Minimum 2 person is there. If there are 2 person and 1 partner dies on some certain exigency, then the partnership will dissolve. When there is a 3 person, another person goes leave the partnership, then the 2 person have to carry the partnership either with the same name or with the new name. Lawful business, because it should be registered, it should be have a deed, an agreement is there. Court should accept it, because law is very important. Because in future, when there are 2-3 partners are there, they have to be lawfully tactful and lawfully dealt, because the concept of profit arises, the concept of capital investment arises. The law is very essential. The business should be legally acceptable. Sharing of profit, you have to see in the partnership deed what is mentioned, whether share of profit should be in the, as per the profit sharing ratio, or it should be, if they not mention anything in the partnership deed, it should be shared equally. Or in the partnership deed, it may be written, it should be said in the capital contribution ratio. Suppose one may be contributing 10 lakh, another may be contributing 2 lakh. So the 10 lakh person will be getting, and the ratio will be 10:2. So he will get more share of profit. Mutual agency. Mutual agency means each partner act as an agent of another partner. Each partner act as an agent of the partnership fund. We know the partnership, when they form business, that is known as partnership. It is a process. And the firm and the name given to the business is known as a partnership firm. Unlimited liability, joint and several liability, we have discussed. Then when the liability is unlimited, means not only the business property will be taken from the partnership, but also the personal property will also be taken into account. In case of any loan taken from the bank, if they are found dissolved, one of the any partners has taken any loan, without informing or with informing, then a whole of the partners are responsible, jointly or separately. Ownership and control jointly head, both all the partners are acting, and they can act as owner. We have discussed as co-owner, and they are also control. They have control on each other. The ownership control are jointly held. Non-transferability of shares. The shares cannot be transferred in case of partnership. In case of company, we'll discuss later, the share can be transferred. But in case of partnership, share cannot be transferred, because you are a partner of the organization, you are an owner of the organization. So you have signed the partnership deed. There is an agreement. You cannot transfer the share so easily. And in case of partnership, registration not compulsory, but nowadays the organization is, the situation is changing, registration has become compulsory. But before, the partnership registration was not compulsory. Now the act has not been amended. But many also organizations, they do partnership without also proper registration. But now it has become compulsory. Next slide. What are the elements of partnership? One element is there should be an agreement. Agreement is a must. It's the basis of association between partner. An agreement is it should be in the written form. Two or more person is essential, because 2 person should be there to have a common goal. And minimum number of partners is 2, and there is a constant on the maximum number of partners. There should not be more than the extent or beyond the maximum number of partners. So minimum member should be 2. When there is a less than 2, then it is not a partnership business. This is another cardinal rule for partnership. Sharing of profit. Another important thing, the sharing of profit is that business is there to share profit and loss. But definition of partnership held, it tells that is an association between people who have consented to share the gain of a business. The share of loss is implicit. See, always when you start business, we are essential that we are very much dedicated that we want to have profit and we'll share a profit. But when there is a loss, that affects each and every partner. So sharing of loss is inevitable and it is inherent. Every partner should also share the loss also, so that business can carry on in future very prosperously. Another thing is that business motive. What is business motive? It is important for the firm to carry on some kind of business. Business means the business should have some profitable motive. Business should have profitable aspect. We know every business is carried on to gain some profit. Then mutual business. The partners are the owner and agent. You know, I have already told, they are the owner and agent. They have each other of the business also. Any act performed by one partner can affect another partner and the firm. This is really applicable purely in case of unlimited liability where it is an impact on the business. One partner is taking a loan for the organization, other partner is in, does not know. Still, the business is affected and the partners are affected. Then there are jointly and severally liable. Their business property also liable and their personal property will be also be liable. It can be concluded that this point acts as a test of partnership for all. This is the important test of partnership. Next slide. And as for the syllabus, there is also an objective of partnership. Our objective of partnership is that when the partnership business is started, then they use it a mutual trust. Because 2 person or 3 person or 4 person, they do a business. Every person has different mentality, different thinking. So that's an important thing of a partnership. You should have trust. Number two, compatibility when creating great business partners. What are compatibility? The audience should be better. You need to have good compatibility with the audience, offering, the location, and the company culture. Unless and until you have a good rapport with the audience and you have a good social awareness and having a good geographic location of the company and company culture is the need of the hour, then only you can prosper. Shared vision and clear objective. Each and every partner should share the vision to have a clear objective, and the common goal should be framed. At the end of the day, main objective is to improve the business and to gain profit so that every partner should get some benefit from the business. And transparency. It is the icing on the cake, because you know transparency is very important, proper communication is essential, and the goal should be clear. Coming to next slide, what is the advantage and limitation of partnership? Advantage is that it is easy for formation. You have to go to the register of firm, ROF. You have to fill up the form, and with minimum 2 person, with the less legal formalities, you can start a business of partnership. Large financial resources, 2 person are there, in sole trader 1 person are there, 2 person. So 2% money is invested, so large financial resources. Then coming to balanced decision making. Balanced decision making means before that only 1 person was making decision. The decision may be wrong, decision may be correct, decision may be wrong. So here 2 person will take decision. Obviously the expertise idea will mix into together. In a proper good decision, balanced decision may take place. Incentive to work hard. If you apart from that partner, there is some incentives given also. Extra work you do. Incentives are given also. The partners also do extra work. And so status to all partners are equal, irrespective of their of the contribution, but the profit sharing ratio and capital contribution is a major factor that has an important role in case of contribution to the business. But every partner is an owner, co-owner of the organization. Secrets of business may have to maintain. So 2-3 partners are there. Every secret, state secret of business has to maintain the cost price of the goods sold, the profit margin, the market price, everything should be kept confidential. Dividend risk is very important, because when you this is very rare in case of dividend risk. When you are providing any dividend, any profit, any bonus, so you have to give equal bonus to everybody. But nowadays they are not giving dividend, so that risk is very less. Advantage of partnership facilitation, I've already told, when the partner is from science background, another partner is from arts background, another partner is from commerce background. So they will specialize in the particular area. Flexibility operation, also the partnership also has a much more scope for flexibility operation. two, three persons are there, so they can have different types of operation, different types of business process under them. These are all the advantages. Limitation, coming to the limitation, unlimited liability. Unlimited liability is very important demerit also. Not only the business property of the partners will go to by the when they found a insolvent, personal property of the each and every partner will also be at stake. Uncertainty of existence means when there is a two partner and one partner dies or something happened to him, then the partnership automatically breaks down. Even if the business is running very well, then how to make it existence again is a very difficult task to make the partnership run. Delayed decision making, sometimes this already you have discussed in advantage and also this is a disadvantage. When one person is there, the one person takes the decision quickly and easily. And when the two person, there may be some difference in opinion, so that decision may also take time. Risk of implied authority of partner, I have also told that each and every partner act as an agent and owner of each other, so every partner should they have a faith and trust on each other. So sometimes also doubt and integrity arises among the partner on each other. Conflict and collusion also arises. So this hampers the business profitability also. Fear of competitive business, the same partner, four or five partners are there and one of partners leave the business organization and go and start the same business which he was before. So competitive business takes place among the partners very rarely. And because if they are not given proper space and environment and proper profit, they do the same type of business elsewhere. Unsuitable of big venture is very risk and not suitable. So company form organization was suggested for the big venture. Non-transferred owners, partners cannot transfer his owner to some other person. If he is found dead, then his wife or son, if eligible, is provided. Or new organization is started with a new name, so he cannot transfer his ownership. They have to forge the partnership deed. Next slide. Different types of partnership. This I am telling in general. General partnership is there which consists of two or more members to run a business. In this partner, each partner represents firm with equal rights. All partners can participate in management decision and have right to control the business. Similarly, profit, debt, and liability are equally shared and divided equally. Everybody has equal say. Limited partnership. Both general and limited partner, the limit general partner has unlimited liability, manage the business and other limited liability. Limited partner has limited control of the business. They do not have unlimited control. Only they are limited to the investment they make. They are not associated to everyday operation of the business. Limited liability partnership is a very new concept. Now the partnership firm are coming under this. Each partner is guided against other legal and financial mistake. A limited liability partners are almost similar to a limited liability company. Means not only the private property, only the business property is still at stake if found any insolvent. But different from a limited private partnership or general partnership. So if one partner makes this make a wrong decision, the other partner is not affected. Partnership at will. It defined as when there is no clause mentioning the expiration of partnership firm under Section 7 of the Indian Partnership 1932, two conditions have to fulfill to become a partnership at will. The partnership firm should not have any fixed expiry date and no particular determination of partnership should be mentioned. Anytime the partnership, if he wishes, he can dissolve. He can make the firm to expire. And then if there nothing is mentioned in the agreement and no particular wish or particular thing of partnership should be mentioned. And then coming to kinds of partner, next slide. Partnership at will, already have discussed. Partnership at fixed period. It should be mentioned in the agreement the partnership is for this number of period, then we have to continue the partnership for a fixed number of period or for the purpose for which it is established. Particular partnership, a partnership can be formed for continuous business and formed for a particular venture, a particular project. After the particular venture project completed, the partnership is dissolved, that is known as particular partnership. General partnership we have discussed, formation to carry out the business and for all the each and every member, the treated as equal. Coming to next slide, it is known as partnership deed. Very, very important. This is also known as partnership agreement. It contains the record of the rights and functions and utilities of all the partners of the organization. And this agreement is very essential, maybe written oral, but written as preferred, but it acts as an evidence in future in court of law. Coming to the, it normally comprises attributes that all characters influence the association between the partners. counting the aim of trade, contribution of capital, by each of the partner, the ratio in which the gain or losses with divided partner, and privilege and entitlement of partner to interest on loan, interest on capital, etc. This section of partnership deed can be modified with the accord of all the partners. The deed must be appropriately drafted and outlined in the provision of the stamp act. It tells us that it should be registered with the register of firm. I've already discussed ROF, where there is an office, we have to go and register a partnership. And before there was written or agreement also take place, but now the oral agreement also take place. But now written agreement is more preferred. And we know there is maybe legal complaints in future, so written agreement is preferred. But it can also take place in oral form, because we can know the aim of the business, the contribution of capital, and the ratio will, in which they will gain the share, the profit loss, and the privilege they are getting on interest loan, interest on capital. Then written is more preferred. Coming to next slide, registration of partnership deed. All rights and responsibilities member are documented in a document known as partnership deed. The deed is an oral agreement. Again, I'm telling, oral agreement is of no use and firm is to deal with the tax. So few essential things are named. Name of the firm is essential in case of registration. Name and address of partner, name of the nature of business, which type of business you're doing, manufacturing, trading, service matter, term of duration of the partners, the amount of capital contributed by each partner, drawings, the interest to be allowed on capital in and charge on drawing, rights of partner, duties of partner, remuneration to partner, the method used for calculating goodwill, profit or loss sharing, this section is repeated, already have discussed. Next slide. What are the contents of partnership deed? The contents of partnership deed are the date of business, headquarter, branch address, duration, who is partner, contributed how much, what is the profession ratio, salary, interest on capital, contribution, retirement, any suspension term, condition, preparation business account, who will maintain the account, legal audit, internal audit, how to dissolve, any conflict arises, what are the guidelines. Many are there, I've only highlighted the important things. What are the rights of partner? The right of partner is that to help in the conduct of business. Right of partner that they should be consulted in all matters. A right of partner is that they have a right to access all records, books and accounts of the business and examine it. And right of partner is that they have to share the profit equally if nothing is mentioned in the agreement. The right of partner is that when partner has contributed more than the agreed share of capital is entitled to interest at the rate of 6% per annum, but no interest can be claimed on capital. Right of partner is that he be entitled to indemnified for the firm harm done by him in the course of partnership business. Any irregularities or any legalities, he has to bear with that. Partner is joint owner of the partnership property, is entitled to a partnership property, used exclusively for the purpose of the partnership. Whatever property he is using in the business, he has to use for the business. And there should be difference between personal and professional property. He has to act in emergency for protecting the firm from loss, but he must act reasonably. In case of any loss arising from the business, he can. Any partner can do anything for the business to protect the business, but it should be in a reasonable way. Partner is entitled to prevent the introduction of new partners without his consent. So introduction of a new partner is very essential. So any reference given or any partner is being a new partner, so consent is essential. Every partner has a right to retire as per the deed and with the consent of the other partner. The partner says he can retire by giving notice to all the other partners. Every partner has the right to continue in the partnership. These are the duties and power you can discuss. Next slide. Every partner is bound to diligently carry on the business of the firm, greatest advantage, these are duties of the partner. Every partner must be faith, honest and faithful, just to the other partner. Every partner is bound to render true, proper and correct accounts of the partnership to each other and must also permit other partners to inspect and copy such accounts. Suppose one partner is keeping an account and other partner want to investigate the accounts. So the partner who is maintaining the account cannot prevent the other partner from investigating because all are the co-owners of the organization. Another duty of the partner is that they may be bound to indemnify the firm for any losses caused by willful act. Because of the partnership, any losses arise to the organization, then the partner should bear it. Partner must not carry out competitive business. So the partner is working in a partnership firm and the same partner is having a separate organization and using the same business and making competition among the firm and his personal business. So that he should not do. He must hand over the firm any profit made by him, but he must himself suffer in loss. That means the partners himself may suffer in loss. He should not affect the business and other partners. This is the duty. share losses equally is very important, because nobody wants to suffer loss. A partner is bound to act with the scope authority. Where the scope rules regulation, he cannot go beyond the rules regulation, what is mentioned in the deed agreement. No partner may assert a transfer his partnership interest. I have already told ownership. Next, the difference between partnership and co-ownership. See, partnership arises as a contract, and co-ownership of partnership arises otherwise also. Purpose of partnership is carrying a business. Purpose of co-ownership not business, but to have ownership. Purpose of partnership is mutual agency, trust between each other, but co-ownership does not have no mutual agency. Co-ownership, you can see the three brothers having a property and three are the owner. But it's not a partnership. Three are the owner, they do not have mutual agency. And do not have the purpose of carrying on the business. Very simple example, the co-ownership deals with the property. When the two or three brothers are there having a building of their own and it is on given on the rent. Partnership, partner cannot transfer the interest without consent, but a co-owner can transfer in favor of third party. And partnership, the partition cannot be done, but in case of co-ownership, partition is possible. Then coming to next unit, that is appropriation account, or is known as PL appropriation account, profit and loss appropriation. What is appropriation? Setting aside money for a specific purpose. From where do you set aside? From the profit loss account. It is an additional accounting statement. Appropriation account or PL account, additional accounting statement is required for a partnership. Accounting refers to the breakdown of how farm profit is divided. For the government or an account that shows the fund government department has been credited with. It is also known as delegation of cash for the necessity of business operations for the other period. In sole trader, the profit for the year is simply transferred to the credit side of the proprietor capital account. So the proprietor has a capital and he can appropriate wherever he wants. In case of partnership, in case of appropriation account, profit will be credited to PL appropriation rather than capital account. See, in case of sole trader, we are transferring to the capital account. But in case of partnership, we will have a separate account known as PL appropriation. That from the PL, the amount of money that we are making aside will go to PL appropriation account. As EL appropriation is dealt with, the double rated system is completed through entering both appropriation accounts. So when you are having PL appropriation account, you know that we have to follow the double rated system. And the partner current account, if current accounts are not maintained, the partner, the entry will mean the capital account. Next slide. That is profit loss account. I already know it is a financial statement which tells us about revenue, cost, expenses during a particular period, usually a financial year, a fiscal year. It is in a more related to the income statement. The records give information about company ability and inability to generate cash by revenue and reducing costs. Some refer to PL statement, the statement of PL, income statement of operation. This other name of profit loss account, statement of financial results or income, earning statement or expenses statement. This is very important because the learners should know what are the other names of profit loss account. There may be a question, the learner may be confused. What are the other names of financial PL statement? PL profit loss account means how company handles profit loss statement for revenue and cost management. What about the source of income, what are the expenses, how profit is generated, and be growth of the net profit. Next slide. This is a format of an appropriation account. Imagine the figures have been put. See, the PL appropriation account for the year ended 31st 12 2008. Suppose the net profit is transferred from the PL to this by on the credit side, put on the credit side. My net profit is 75,000. Drawings are the interest of drawing. There, suppose there are two partners. Interest of drawing is calculated in working note 3 and it is given in partner A and B. And any transfers are made on the debit side. Interest in capital to partner A and B are given. Salary to partner A and B are also given. And commission to partner also given to A and B. It's an imaginary figure. And the remaining is transferred to partners in the equal sharing ratio. So see, in case of appropriation account, you mark three things. One is drawings, interest on drawing, interest on capital, and salary and commission. Salary, commission, interest on capital, and interest on drawing. These things in taken into account with reserve. See, this is provision and reserve. There was a question in the syllabus, what is the charge against profit and appropriation of profit? The charge against profit is known as a provision and appropriation of profit is known as a reserve. Because when you are appropriation of profit, you are getting some profit from aside, making aside some from the profit for the future. And provision means you are making a charge against profit, you are deducting that because you know it is made for known liability. You know that there will be liability. In case of reserve, we don't know what is the future liability. And provision is used for purpose only, and reserve can be used for future purpose. I want to tell here in partnership, the provision is here, it deals with charge against profit. reserve here deals with appropriation of profit. Provision is shown above the line and reserve is shown below the line, you know. Above the line means PL account and below the line means PL appropriation account. Provision always is shown in the PL account and reserve is transferred to PL appropriation. This is a very important thing, already shown in PL appropriation account. And interest on drawing, interest on capital, salary commission, reserve plays very important role in PL appropriation account. This is the difference between fixed capital and fluctuating capital in partnership. There are two types of capital. Fixed capital, you know, the capital remain unchanged, and fluctuating the in fluctuate from period to period. In case of fixed capital, we maintain two accounts, capital and current account. And in case of fluctuating capital, one account is maintained, current capital accounts. Mark the sentence. This is a very important sentence. In case of fixed, two accounts are maintained because the account is fixed, so we have to maintain current account differently. In case of fluctuating, only one account is maintained. In fixed, all adjustments are done in capital account, but in the fluctuating, all adjustments are done in current account. Adjustment may be relating to drawing, salary, etc. Fixed account never show a negative balance, but fluctuating capital account always can show a negative balance. This is another example of fixed and fluctuating. Already I have discussed. And see, and again, I discussed the nature of account remain unaltered, it remain fixed. And see, the 5 points specifically mentioned, this is specifically mentioned in the partnership deed, fixed capital account or fluctuating capital account. Fluctuating is not necessary mentioned. Fixed capital account also credit balance, fluctuating sometimes may show debit balance. Next slide. Difference between PL and PL appropriation. See, PL account is prepared after preparation of trading account. PL appropriation is prepared after preparation of PL account. And PL account is prepared by all business concerned, but PL appropriation account is prepared by partnership firm and company. This is a very important thing. PL appropriation account is prepared only by partnership firm and company. PL account, the account does not have opening closing balance profit, but PL appropriation may have opening and closing balance. See, this is a format of capital account and current account learners should know. Partners capital account, see, balance brought down, opening balance. To balance, credit on closing balance, cash, any cash or bank withdrawn, additional cash invested by bank, cash bank, particulars and details amount, particular details amount. This is the debit side and this credit side. And this is but the partner's capital current account. See, buy balance brought down, opening balance, then to balance, credit on closing balance, opening balance, to balance brought down, and if closing balance, debit balance, or buy balance, credit on. The drawings again, interest drawings put on debit side, PL account, if there is a loss. On the credit side, interest and capital is good, partner salary or commission is good, PL appropriation is good. Next slide. See, this is an example. We'll solve the problem. And the example tells us that July 1, 2018, A and B enter into partnership and contribute 2,50,000, 1,30,000, and 1,20,000 respectively, and share profit in the ratio of 5:3:2. B and C are entitled to a salary of 16,000 and 14,500 respectively per year. Interest on capital is to be allowed at 5% per annum. 5% interest to be charged on drawing. During the year, A withdraw 40,000, B 25,000, C 15,000. Interest being A, ₹2,250, B 1,125, and C 725. Profit in 2018, before the above mentioned adjustment, was 71,400. So the profit is distributed, prepare capital account if they are fluctuating, if they are fixed. We'll solve. We'll prepare a profit loss account, appropriation account. The capital are fluctuating, you have to mention capital account. The capital are fixed, you have to upon capital and current account. They put the net profit, which is given as 71,400 in PL appropriation account by net profit. And first, put the interest on capital. Interest on capital is given 5%. 5% on 2,50,000 of A, and 5% on 1,30,000 of B, 5% of 1,20,000 of C. It is coming at 12,500, 6,500, 6,000. Put on debit side. So it is coming at 25,000. Partner salary already it is given 16,000 and 14,500. Put on debit side. Interest in drawing. It is given at 5%. The drawing amount is given 40,000, 25,000, 15,000. 5% of 40,000. 5%. The interest already given. The amount is already given. Interest amount being 2,250, 1,125, 725. Put that on the credit side. Make the total of the credit side, deduct the total of the debit side, the balance will be is 20,000, and distribute the 20,000 in a ratio of 5:3:2. It will be 10,000, 6,000, 4,000. Profit loss account, appropriation account is closed. Now come to the capital fluctuating, goes to capital account. put the balance by balance bank balance 2,50,000, 1,30,000, 1,20,000 given the question. By capital, international capital we know 12,500, 6,500, 6,000. It is given in the PL appropriation account. Salary also there by salary 16,000, 14,500 in case of B and C, nothing in A. PL appropriation put on 10,000, 6,000, 4,000 ABC. On the debit side, you put the drawings amount. Here, the drawings amount will put 40,000, 28,000, 15,000 ABC given in the question. And then below that, interest on drawing given 2250, 1125, and 725. The balance amount is 2,30,250, 1,32,375, and 1,28,775. After the total of the credit side minus the debit side, the balance amount comes. This in case of capital are fluctuating. In case the capital are fixed, open a capital account, put simple only by bank, the capital amount 2,50,000, 1,30,000, 1,20,000 ABC. On the debit side, to balance credit on, you put the amount and balance it and delete. Come to the next slide. Current account. Here you put the drawings given 40,000, 25,000, 15,000 ABC. And below that, interest on drawing 2250, 1125, 725 of ABC. And on the credit side, you put salary and interest on capital. Interest on capital is given 12,500, 6,500, 6,000 ABC. And salary 16,000, 14,500 of BC only. And the PL appropriation profit 10,000, 6,000, and 4,000 of ABC. So make the total first of C and deduct the total of say total of credit total of the credit side of C minus total of debit side of the C, the balance comes 8,775. Then total of the credit of B minus total of the credit debit of B, the balance comes 2,375. Then make the total of the debit of A minus the total of the credit of A, the balance comes to 19,750. The current account is closed. Come to the next slide. What are the rules to be followed for preparing the appropriation account? If their partnership deed is absent, see the first comes the profit, because many of the problem arises in court in case of legal matter regarding profit and losses. The partner will sell the profit loss equally. I've already discussed. If there is absence and agreement, the partner will sell equally. If there is an agreement and anything is mentioned, then they will carry on as per the agreement. Next, interest on partner's loan in advance. Partners are entitled to get interest on such loan at the rate of 6% per annum. If it is not there, then it will be assumed that it should be equal to 6% per annum in case of interest on loans in advance. Interest on capital. No interest payable to partner of the capital contribution if nothing is mentioned in the partnership deed. And salary and commission. No partners entitled to get salary and commission. The bonus for service rendered. Nothing is mentioned in the partnership deed. Interest on drawing. No interest will charge in drawing by him. Nothing has been mentioned in the partnership deed. Coming to the next slide. There are special items which are included. What are the special items that are taken care of in case of partnership? Interest on capital. You know the interest on capital is an expenses and debited to PL appropriation account. Interest payable to partners, and because interest partner capital account is credited with the amount of interest. Formula, you see the formula. Amount of capital is equal to rate of interest in the period. Accounting treatment in appropriation out of profit will transfer to debit of PL appropriation and credit will be partner capital account. Interest on drawing, another special item. How the interest on drawing treated, average period, you know, should be used when the amount of drawing is uniform and timetable between the two consecutive drawings uniform. This is a very important concept. Interest drawing is income, you know, and it's credited to PL appropriation account. Next slide. Formula of the drawing is amount of drawing into rate of interest in the period. What is accounting treatment? It should be credited to PL appropriation account. Salary to partner, another thing. How the salary of partner is determined? Most of the partnership firm provision salary included, but the amount of partner remuneration decided by the mutual consent. Suppose some percentage of book profit is allowed as partnership remuneration, there are some conditions which should be complied for deduction of salary as expenses and PL account. Salary must be made to working partner only. Salary must be written authorized by partnership deed and must be qualified. Salary must be related to the period after the partnership with debt. Salary allowed to the income tax act will be limited to percentage of book profit is given below. Bin appropriation profit is to be transferred to PL appropriation account and credit should be partnership capital account. Another important item is interest on loan. See, if a partner advances any amount over and above his commitment, it is known as a loan. A loan is taken because to get back in a few days and or to return. Whenever a partner takes a loan, then it should be not mixed with its original capital contributed. Loans should be treated separately apart from in relation to capital contributed by him. Instead of writing in the capital account, a separate account is opened as partner loan account, interest on partner loan to the firm is charged in his profit. Such interest will be allowed where there is profit or not. Such interest as a partner loan is credited to the account and later on transferred to debit or PL account. What is the rate of interest? In case a partner has given loan to the firm, he is entitled to interest on loan at an agreed rate of interest. When there is no agreement to the rate of interest loan, the partner is entitled to rate of interest loan at the rate of 6% per annum. Interest loan account equipment is interest loan account debited to bill account and credited to partner loan account. Another item is commission. Commission and partner allowed if partnership agreement provide the same. The role in there are allowed if there are profit. Commission may be allowed at a percentage of net profit before charging such commission or after charging commission. This is a very important condition. Commission as percentage of net profit before charging such commission is equal to net profit before commission into rate of commission by 100%. Commission as percentage of net profit after charging such commission is equal to net profit before commission into rate of commission divided by 100% plus rate of commission. What is the treatment? Commission to partner being in appropriation or out of profits will be transferred to debit of PL appropriation. The PL appropriation account debited, credit will be partner capital. Third part of this PPT, the admission of a partner. Sometimes it's very difficult. How, why, and when partners are added? Sometimes it's difficult to run a partnership. Sufficient capital is not there. Manager help is not there. So manager, the firm decide to admit a new partner. But according to the Partnership Act 1932, no partner can be admitted without the consent of all existing partners. A person who is admitted as a partner does not thereby become liable for any act done before his admission. Only after his admission he becomes liable. What is the meaning? During ordinary course of business, the partnership's business may need additional capital skill when, because of the same reason, some importance, partners welcomes outside the partner in the business, that is known as admission of partner. Sometimes the partners are not willingly to contribute much more amount of money and without a managerial capacity, so very expert person from outside also may be welcome to be a part of the partnership. Before giving admittance to new partner, there should be clear-cut consent between among the partners for the same. Otherwise, there will be dissolution of partners. Because when the partner will come, if the business is not working well, and after the partner arrival, the business will work well, the new partner will take all this credit. Or after the admission of the partner, the organization is working well, whatever the profit margin, after the new partner is admitted, and you want to take that profit margin and the goodwill also. So you used to, each and every partner, existing partner, to decide. What is the reason? The detailed investigation reason for an admission of partner, that more capital should be needed, more skilled, competent, experienced person is needed, business should be expanded, more human capacity, human person is needed, business should be boosted, goodwill, to increase the goodwill, reputed person may be introduced to reduce competition, to take advantage of the experience, reputation, goodwill with incoming partner. It may be also reconstitution of partnership firm, ending the existing agreement, new organization, now new name may be given, new firm may be thought of. A new partnership agreement may also come into existence, a new partnership there. That also may cause a new partnership deed may also be prepared at the time of admission of a new partner. That may be also a cause. And what is the aspect of admission of a new partner? A newly admitted partner has two rights. One is sharing future profit and sharing asset of the firm. Adjustment needed to be time made at the hour. What are the adjustment made at the admission of partner? Calculation of new profit sharing ratio of all the partners, accounting treatment of goodwill, accounting treatment for evaluation of assets and liability. Assets and liability should be devalued. Accounting treatment for reserve and accumulated profit and adjustment of capital on the basis of new profit sharing ratio. Next slide. What is new profit sharing ratio? The ratio in which all partners, including new partners, should share the future profit and loss. That is known as new profit sharing ratio. How it is calculated? When only the ratio of new partners is given in the question, then in absence of any instruction, it is assumed that all partners will continue to share the remaining profit in the same ratio. In this, they were sharing before the admission of new partner. The new partner will suppose purchase share of profit from the old partner equally. In such case, the new profit sharing ratio of the old partner will be ascertained by deducting the sacrifice ratio made by them from the existing share of profit. So, new profit ratio will be old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Third, when the new partner purchase share from the profit from the old partner particular ratio, then in such case, the new profit sharing ratio of the old partner will be calculated after deducting the sacrificing made by partner for the existing share of profit, that is new profit ratio is old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Four, when the old partner surrender a particular fraction of share in favor of new partner, then surrender share is going to surrender share into old SEO, and new SEO will be old SEO minus surrendering share, and sacrificing SEO will be old SEO minus new SEO. Next, what is gaining SEO? It is calculated time of retirement of debt of partner because somebody will gain is excess of new SEO, old SEO. And when a partner is admitted, I have already discussed, the new ratio is calculated. When the partner will retire or die, then gaining ratio will be decided. So it is excess of new ratio over old ratio of old partner except retirement and death. Gaining ratio is called new ratio minus old ratio. And what is the difference between gaining and sacrificing ratio? Sacrificing ratio is calculated at time of admission of a partner. Gaining ratio is calculated at time of retirement of a partner. Total of each old partner sacrifice will be equal to new ratio be equal new admitted partner. And total of gaining share of each partner will be equal to old ratio of retired partner. Goodwill will be distributed time of admission in sacrificing ratio. Goodwill will be distributed time of retirement gaining ratio. This is a very important point. And difference of old ratio and sacrificing ratio will be new ratio. But total of old ratio and gaining ratio will be new ratio in case of retirement. Next slide. What is goodwill? We know that goodwill is the reputation of the firm, and the concept of goodwill arises here in the partnership. And the concept of goodwill arises here in partnership of firm. And the name of firm organization, you know, the reputation of firm known as goodwill. And the name of firm of organization can be known as goodwill. In the beneath merit of good name, reputation, measure of capacity of business to earn more profit. Intangible asset, you know, the value of reputation of firm, the value asset if concern is profitable. It is useless if a concern is losing concern. So it is extra sellable value attached to a business beyond the intrinsic value of an asset. Beyond the fixed value, there may be some additional goodwill, reputation, value of the organization. We know value of goodwill are two types. One is inherent goodwill and another is purchase goodwill. They can be known as internal goodwill and external goodwill. Internal goodwill known as inherent goodwill. A business may have a long period of time having good selling good product, quality product. And purchase goodwill are known as external goodwill. When you're purchasing a business, new business you purchase, and the purchase consideration is calculated, which is more than the value of tangible asset received. Then that is known as purchase goodwill. Next slide. Why there is need of valuation of goodwill? See, in case of sold property, goodwill is valued at the time selling of business. When one business is sold, value of the business for the cost and any goodwill attached. Because any person taking any business, partnership business, or making converting the company sole proprietor into company or sole proprietor into partnership, the value is, goodwill is valued at that time. But in case of partnership, when there is admission, retirement, and death, also amalgamation, conversion of company, and change in profit setting, so then goodwill is determined. In case of company, goodwill is determined time the amalgamation to our company, absorption of the company, reconstruction, and holding. The valuation of goodwill is very important because shares are valued on the basis of interesting value, market value, or fair value, and the stock quotation, exchange quotation of the value of share is not available. Because the price of the goodwill of this increasing, decreasing, and it depends on the situation and the market value and on the product and all the business organization and value addition and name and fame of the organization. Taxes and purpose, wealth tax, and valuation goodwill is also necessary. Next slide. Different methods of valuation goodwill and very essential if the method should be mentioned in the partnership deed, which method should be adopted. If no mention is method, no method is mentioned, then there are different types of method. One is average profit. That you calculate total profit of the suppose 4 or 5 years and calculate the profit divided by the number of years and see the how much goodwill the number of years the goodwill is taken. Goodwill is taken 3 years or 2 years and multiply with that. First, calculate the profit of the last suppose 5 years. In the example I've given 80,000, 90,000, 70,000, 85,000, 1 lakh. So total is coming as and divide the number of by number of years 5. Total is 85,000. And goodwill is suppose goodwill is for 3 years. Then you divide it, multiply 85,000 into 3, it will be 2,55,000, the valuation of goodwill under average profit method. In case of super profit method, suppose a firm is able to earn more than the normal expected profit, then it is known as super profit. Capital of the business is 4 lakh and 15% rate is there, and normal profit is 60,000, average profit is 85,000, and super profit comes to 25,000, the super profit is multiplied. Next slide. So 25,000 is the super profit, and the number of years 3, the super 25,000 into 3, that is comes to 75,000. Same question carries in case of capitalization method, and the business, the whole business is 85,000, percentage rate is 15%, so 85,000 to 15% is coming as 566,667, net asset is given 4 lakh, the goodwill will be difference between the whole of the value minus net asset. So value is 566,667. And it's 4 lakh. So below goodwill under capitalization method will be 166,667. coming to another method, there are five methods. Four methods is capitalization super profit method. It got released divided by capitalization ratio with the difference between adjusted forecast maintenance profit and rate of return on capital employed. Adjustable forecast maintenance profit is 80,000. Normal rate of return is 20%. Capital employed is 4 lakh and capitalization rate is 20%. Goodwill is equal to 80,000 minus 4 lakh divided by and 4 lakh into 15% divided by 20%. That will be coming 1 lakh valuation of goodwill. Annuity method simple. The average profit into annuity rate. Average profit last is given to 2 lakh. The normal rate is given as 5 lakh 20%. So for 2 lakh minus 5 lakh into 20%, the rate is 3.7907 regarding the period and the time rate. It is coming 379070. Basically, the capitalization super profit method and this super profit method is more adapted in case of calculation goodwill. Then we will go to next slide, accounting treatment of goodwill. Another accounting treatment. In case of admission of admission of partner, when the amount of goodwill premium is paid privately, then no it is there. And the new partner being share of goodwill premium in case, and the heading is that the amount of goodwill premium bought by new partner is written in business, then cash account debited to goodwill account. Another entry is that goodwill account debited. Next entry is that goodwill account debited in sacrificing ratio to old partner capital account. And the goodwill premium brought in by new partner withdrawn by the old partner, then old partner capital account debited to cash account or to bank account. In the case of check, the bank will come. In case of cash, then cash account will come. And goodwill already appears in the books and new partner being the share of goodwill premium cash. First of all existing goodwill account will have to be written up. You write up all the existing goodwill account in case of old ratio. For the purpose, old capital accounts are debited in old ratio and goodwill account is credited. Old capital account debited to goodwill account in old ratio. Remaining entry remains same for bringing goodwill in cash. When the new partner does not bring goodwill premium in cash, the new partner capital account debited from his share of goodwill to old partner capital account in sacrificing ratio. When the goodwill appears in the books and new partner doesn't bring share of goodwill premium in cash, when the new partner brings only a part of his goodwill in cash, cash account debited to goodwill, another goodwill account debited to new partner capital account or to old partner capital account sacrificing ratio. Sometimes already discussed that assets and liability also revalued in case of admission. Account which is prepared to record changes in the asset value is also this liability also increases decreases in case of admission, retirement, death, or in change of profit sharing ratio of existing partner. We have to revalue. See, this is a format of revaluation account. We will solve a problem also on revaluation account. The debit side, see, provision for doubtful debt, machinery, furniture, outstanding electricity, profit transfer to AB. By land and building, investment, prepaid expenses. So you have to know the revaluation account, how the amount is transferred and charged, increase in asset and decrease in liability, increase in asset. You know, there is reduction value of asset, then revaluation account should be debited and assets account should be credited. And when there is an increase in asset, then asset will be debited, revaluation account will be credited, and vice versa in case of liability. See, this is the new partner admitted. We have discussed in detail. This I am also showing it to you. Also, we have discussed. I'm coming to a problem. It's important problem on revaluation. See, A and B are partners in a firm selling profit in the ratio of 3:1. The balance sheet of the 31st December 2018 was forgiven. Creditor 1800, workmen compensation fund 1200, journalist of 2100. Capital KB given 6,000, 4,900. Bank 1,000, rails is 2,500. Debtor 4,000, less provision 500. So 3,500, stock 3,000, investment 5,000, goodwill 1,000. Total 16,000 on debit and credit. On the above date, C is admitted for 2/5 of share in the profit of the firm. And the following revaluation is made. See here, you are required to prepare revaluation account, partner capital account, and balance sheet. The accrued income not appearing in the book is 100. These are all revalued revaluation figure. This will all take place in will be posted in revalued account debit credit side. Market value of investment is 4,500. Claim on account of workmen compensation is estimated at 150. X, an old customer whose account was written off as bad, who promised to pay 350 in settlement of his full debt. C is required to bring 8,000 in capital and 2,000 goodwill. A share of goodwill was calculated 2,400. So first we'll prepare the revaluation account. See, the income, the accrued income is 100, make a revaluation account, put in on credit side by accrued in 100, workmen compensation fund, sorry, second is market value invested in 4,500, before, see, the investment is being given to the in the balance sheet, 31st December 2018 is 5,000. So there is decrease investment for revaluation account debited to your asset or investment 500 put 500 in debit side. Any increase in increase in asset put on credit side. Markman compensation fund, see it is 150. There was before 1200. So deduct that 150. It will be 1050. Then again, an ex and old customer whose account was written with bad debts promised to pay 350 in settlement debt. Any you are getting an income put on credit side by 350 by ex. The total is 1500 minus 500. The balance will be distributed in case of 3:1 capital ratio. A and B, 750 to 50, 1,000. The total is 1,500 for each side. So transfer the profit to capital account. I transfer the amount to capital account 6,000, 9,000 of A and B. Generally, the view transfer 2100 transfer in the ratio of 3:1. Revaluation is transfer 750 to 50 in the ratio of 3:1. And bank amount is 1,000. And also, there was investment in case of 8,000 in capital. C has brought 8,000. And 2,000 is goodwill. The 2,000 goodwill of C will be distributed in the ratio of 3:1 among A and B. So by bank, it is given. And the same should be provided in the credit side of the capital account. Goodwill, 750-250. The capital, C, the goodwill was 1,000. And we calculated goodwill bought by the C, the total amount of goodwill bought by C, 2,000. And share of goodwill was calculated 2,400. So C has brought 2,000, but his share of goodwill calculated 2,400. The extra 400 was there. The extra 400, he should get more 400. This should be shared by both A and B. To A capital account on debit side of capital account, 300 in the ratio of 3:1. To B capital account, 100. So that is also put on credit side to C capital account. C will get from A 300 and B from B 100. So total both the credit side of A, B, C, 10,125, 6,275, 8,000. So deduct the debit side from 10,125, 750, the balance is coming 9,375. 6,275 deduct 250, balance is 6,025. 8,000 deduct 300, 100, it will be 7,600. The total of debit, total of credit balanced. Now the balance sheet is to prepare. The bank is 1,000. We have already bought 10,000, 8 plus 2, so 10,000 plus 1,000, 11,000. Bills receivable is same, 2,500. The debtor is increased from by 350. We have bought previously debtor, so 4,000 plus 350 minus 500, 3,850. Stock is remaining same. Investment will be market value 4,500. Accrued income will be added 1,000. And the goodwill internally, that is of internal goodwill, so no issue because of new preparation of new balance sheet. Already 400 of excess difference written in the notes as debited C capital and creditor to old partner capital account in the securitizing this one. Creditor is remaining 1,800. Workman compensation fund new figure is 150. And the general ledger has been distributed to the capital of OAB. So the new capital already you have found out 9,375,6025,7,600. That comes 23,000. Total balance sheet is balance 24,950. This is the total of the today's the slide is over. Amido.
Hello. Sir, namaskar.
Sir, namaskar.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, Rani, sir.
Achcha. Ho. Amido,
yes, sir. Good morning, sir. Yes, sir. Good morning.
Up. Thank you very much for taking pen in organizing the class.
No, sir.
Thank
no,
you, sir.
Well,
thank you very much for once again accepting our invitation.
Thank
and,
you, sir.
Lucidly elaborating on the topic. We are expecting your cooperation further also.
Thank you
very much. And Amit, if you permit, we can be linked from the link now.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.